All right, so we're at the end of the day here at 500 Startups. Hi, Dave. Yes. Oh, Filipinos. And we're really excited to present to you guys Twit Music, and they're from the Philippines, and I'm very proud because we love startups from the Philippines. But anyway, not to talk too much over you guys, but this is Steph. He's one of the co-founders of Twit Music, and this is Sandra.
Nice to meet you.
And she does all of the marketing. And thank you so much for being here, and congratulations on your demo today. So let's talk about Twit Music for those people who don't know.
Yeah, so Twit Music lets musicians post their tracks to Twitter and Facebook, and we provide tools for artists to increase their followers and reach new audiences. And it's mainly based on the Twitter platform, but artists right now can post to Facebook, and we intend to expand to other platforms in the future.
And that's really interesting because, you know, MySpace was so huge and really kind of elevated that artist community. Is that something that you're trying to replicate on your platform?
Absolutely. In fact, we've spoken to a lot of major labels, and for them, what really matters is building a fan base and increasing their reach genuinely. So on Twit Music, we provide all these great platforms for artists to do that, to increase their Twitter followers, to really promote their music effectively. And right now, Twit Music is free. We're not charging anything for it. We really just want to genuinely help artists out there promote their music in real time and spread like wildfire if possible. And sign up literally takes a minute. You just got to go to twitmusic.com, hit, you know, create account, and yeah, in 1 minute, boom, you've got a Twit Music page set up and you're ready to upload tracks.
Perfect.
Now, Steph, what was it that made you realize this was something that was necessary out there?
Well, so the concept initially started when we saw a lot of musicians migrating to Twitter, and they were posting their tracks, but they were linking their followers to sites like SoundCloud or even MySpace or Facebook, even YouTube. But when these followers went to these sites, there was no way for them to kind of share that track back onto Twitter, except the really boring tweet button. So what we provide on the Twit Music song page are these sharing tools for every Twitter follower to share back the track in very creative ways. Like you can hashtag a song, you can retweet a song, you can love a song, and even comment on it. And everything you do from the site sends back to Twitter to your followers.
So
we're solving a very big problem for the artists in terms of promoting their music on the Twitter platform and virally spreading it. And for the users, we're also solving a problem for them to share the tracks to their friends and followers on Twitter.
And there's so many ways to share music, right? I mean, YouTube is a really huge platform for, you know, artists out there that are looking to become, you know, found by agents and stuff, and managers. So what do you say about, like, you know, what are the collective tools necessary to really get your music out there?
For us, I think it's important to build engagement tools for the users, and not just simple, boring ones, but really fun ones. And Steph touched on the hashtag, for instance, tool. Twitter is big on hashtags, right? So if you go, for instance, onto a Twit Music song page and you're listening to the track, there's different ways to engage. Speaking of the hashtag, let's say you could do hashtag now playing a song by Jason Mraz, or if you really love it, you just hit the love button. And what's really unique about Twit Music is that every time you click one of our engagement buttons, since we're so smoothly integrated to Twitter, this broadcasts out to your existing followers, so your own network. So let's say, Arabella, you have a Twitter account and you go on Twit Music and you listen to Jason Mraz's song, you click the love button, instantly a tweet sends out on your feed to your friends saying you love this track. And at the same time, Jason Mraz's song link is included in that tweet. So it's very viral inherently. So yeah,
easy to use. It's part of what you're doing, what your activities, the daily activities. So how did your team meet each other?
Well, we met in the Philippines. So we founded Twit Music in the Philippines. I've known Sandra for nearly 7 years. And she had a previous company, a fashion line, that was very successful, and she was in charge of the marketing. So I asked her, hey, why don't you join Twit Music? And here she is.
How long have you been working for Twit Music?
Well, I was already kind of, since I knew them for almost 7 years, I was watching them grow and develop like the 5 months before launch, and they'd also asked me about my insight, my input, and how to effectively build this product. So on the side, while I was at my previous company, I would be advising them and sharing my input. And once they were ready to launch, it was perfect timing. They took me on board, and we just you know, started launching in January, and artists after artists signed up. It was really interesting because we already have a lot of friends who are musicians, so we asked them to get involved first and to test in beta. And we really try to apply the Lean Startup principles by Eric Ries, which are really to get the MVP out there, you know, test it, get feedback. And that's why we have such a great situation right now. Brian Adams is literally on Skype with us, you know, whenever he has time, and you know, we really appreciate that he gives us feedback how to keep the product simple but make it, you know, as effective as possible. And
Brian Adams, a musician?
Yes, the Brian Adams, legendary icon Brian Adams. No, he's awesome. I mean, he was in the Caribbean, just like on a side note, in the Caribbean, and his baby was, like, you know, in the background crying, and he really spent an hour and a half talking to us, so we really appreciate that. And, you know,
Hi, Brian.
And if you go on Twitter, if you go to Brian's song page right now for his recently uploaded track, Don't Look Back, he's almost at 100,000 plays, and we have a great surprise once he reaches that 100,000 play, so watch out for that.
So I have a question. I mean, you guys are on top of it. I mean, your lean startup, you know, methodologies that you're applying, you're really thinking about user experience. I mean, these are things that are very like Silicon Valley, you know, rooted type of ideas. Yeah. And you're coming from the Philippines. What did it take for you guys to stay on top of what it takes to, you know, build your startup?
I think we just work very hard. And, you know, we have a bigger vision. So we want to execute on that bigger vision, and we're doing whatever it takes to kind of build this product and help artists and provide such a great service for and solve a big problem.
Are you guys planning to stay in the Philippines or move to this area?
Eventually, we're going to be moving to either New York or San Francisco.
You don't know yet why?
Well, in New York, obviously all the major labels are there.
Yes. Yes.
And so we have to be based. Like after our demo day in New York, we actually have 11 meetings with labels, and we all booked this in like 1 week. So that is the place to be.
Fabulous. I've got some music contacts that I need to throw to you guys. But really great. If we want to know more about Twit Music, where do we go?
You can check us out at twitmusic.com. Please do follow us on Twitter as well, at twitmusic. And you can follow Stefano at Stefano Fizzini, as well as myself at Sandra Seifert on Twitter. We post like crazy and we update everyone. Please do support us. And if you're a musician or you have friends or musicians, please invite them to sign up. It's free. And we're here for you guys. We're here for the musicians.
I am galing galing. See you. Salamat. Bye.
Thank you so much.
That means thank you. Galing galing means good job. But